Hi guys, good morning. Yeah, it's Monday again, and today I want to talk about the recommendation of the Department of Education in the Philippines to open the schools on August. Okay, so as an educator for 22 years, okay, I have been like teaching in the Philippines for 10 years or more, and here, you know, 12 years in the Philippines, and here in Thailand, like 11 or 10 years, so something like that. Okay, so I have been in academe for more than 2 decades, so I have so many experiences about how to deal with different students. Okay, so this time around the pandemic, the former secretary of the Department of Education said that we cannot let our children to be idle at home. So that's the reason why they recommended to open the schools on August. Okay, let's talk about idle. Okay, so at this point in time of high technology, we have so many things to do to let our children do something at home. Like for example, some families, those who can afford to hire an online teacher for mathematics, science, math, mathematics, English, science, or other languages, they hire teachers to teach their children online. As a matter of fact, even for music lessons, it can be done online because we are in high technology, right? So it's not possible. And some rich families, they're doing that. And at the same day, the parents will going to set a timetable for their children, and then in that timetable, they have scheduled that the kids will start learning at 9 a.m. until 3 o'clock in the afternoon. So they have timetable, they have break also, they have rest, they have time to play, everything. So the activities that they are giving to their children, that includes like taking care of their pets or gardening or tidying up the rooms or baking or any household chores that we can teach to our children. Okay, so there are so many things that we can do to let our children move and be productive and learn something. You know, like for example, taking care of the pets. So it helps them to be responsible children, right? Okay, so you were going to tell me, how about yung pamilya na, those families na hindi mayaman, diba? How about them? Okay, so we have so many old books at home, right? From the older sister, from the older brother, or any teaching materials at home. Okay, so, and I guess 80% of the population in the Philippines, they have Android phone that they are using for Facebook, for everything. So from there, they can search in Google the possible topic that they can teach to their kids, right? So I have a friend here, she has a son, a special child. So she's teaching her son online because she's here and the son is in the Philippines. So it's, come on, that kid is a special child, but why she were able to teach the kid and the kid were able to learn? So it's just a matter of strategy and willingness of the parent to teach their children. So kung mahirap ka, kung hindi ka mayaman, you can teach your children to do gardening, right? From the how you call this? So kung hindi mayaman, katulad ko, mahirap lang, ang ginagawa ko eh, yung mga ano, kunyari magluluto sa bahay, yung kunyari kamatis, yung seed ng kamatis pinapa-dry ko sa mga anak ko, tapos ipapatanim ko. So now, 2 months, more than 2 months nang naka-quarantine, malalaki na yung mga tanim, pati yung chili, pati yung kamatis. So, alam nyo ba kung marami tayong pwedeng ipagawa sa ating mga anak, like for example, drawing, simple mathematics, or whatever. Sabihin, hindi kaya ng magulang dahil hindi sila teacher. You don't need to be a teacher. Diba? As a parent, you don't need to be a teacher to teach your child. Diba? You can teach your child. It's impossible that you cannot. Diba? So, like me, my children are all grown up, right? Okay, 2 of them are working and 1 still in the university. So, the other one, the youngest, who's still in the university, she has a lot of work because of online classes in the university. So, she's working on it. So, she's busy. But she has timetable. In the morning, after waking up, she had to do the yoga on her own and then clean the toilets because that is her assignment. Clean the toilets and then do the work. And then after doing the work, she will have to prepare their lunch, okay? Sometimes her brother cook, but most of the time she does. Okay, so, and then in the afternoon, study again, and, you know, sometimes she sing. She has so many things to do until evening. So, about my 2 children, the second one, because it's working in a restaurant, and it's closed, so I told him, you cannot be just like, sleep, eat, and sleep. Not like that. You have to do something that will make you move. So I assigned him to take care of all the plants at home. So in the morning, before he go to, you know, his morning jogging around the village, he will go in to water the plants first, okay? So after the jogging, of course, he will go to eat and tidy his room and then do something that he loves to do. And then in the afternoon, the same again, water the plant and, you know, some of the plants, he tried to add more soil and, you know, do something to make him busy. And then many things. And then my eldest, he has 3 pets, 3 dogs at home. So he does the cleaning, he does everything about the pets, and of course helping his sister and many things. So just to make them busy. They're grown up, but I still give them the timetable, you know, because of course kids, if no one order to them, they will not move. So I have to push and set a timetable for them. Okay, so it depends on the parents, believe me. Okay, so if we will going to push and let our children go to school because you don't want to your child to be left behind for 1 year, well, you have to think 100 times. Okay, so you gusto mo ba na hindi malate ng 1 year yung anak mo pero mamamatay naman siya? Kaya paano pa siya malilate ng 1 year? Diba? You have to think. Alam niyo ba, like for example, in my place in Cavite, the malls was opened last Saturday. Okay? So, yung mga tao dagsa. Nakalimutan na yung social distancing. So, ayun. We have new 40 cases again in Cavite. So, can you imagine that if your child will go to school, even if you were going to say there is a social distancing that will be imposed in school, you cannot avoid the kids to, you know, to get near with each other. Uh-huh. Because they are kids. The teacher will not look at them for 6 hours. You know, yung teacher kakain din yan, magsi-CR din yan. Paano pag, can you imagine that? And, okay, ikaw, alam mo na ang anak mo ay, kayo lang ang nakakasalamuha. Diba, walang COVID, malinis, kayo lang ang nakakasalamuha. Paano yung kaklase ng anak mo? Sigurado ka ba? Diba? Sigurado ka ba? Paano yung mga kaklase ng mga anak mo? Sigurado ka ba? Diba? So, alam niyo ba ang daming, ang yung dilema, ang daming what if, what if, what if, what if. So, if I were you, it's not about, education is not a contest, you know, that you will going to be ahead of everyone. Okay? So, yung edukasyon, yung eskwelahan, nandyan lang yan. Yung learning, we have continuous learning. You know, we can learn on YouTube, we can learn from our parents, we can teach our children, so many things that we can learn. Our learning surely will not be deprived. Okay, so, kung magkakaisa nga naman ang mga Pilipino na hindi papasukin yung kanilang mga anak, may magagawa ba ang Department of Education? Alam niyo ba ang problema kasi? Yung government schools, possibly hindi sila mag-o-open. Kasi, can you imagine yung bawat isang klase, 40, 45, 50, diba? Ito namang mga private schools, gusto nilang mag-open kasi pag sarado sila, wala silang income. Diba? So, yung bang ano, gusto mo bang makompromise yung life ng yung anak? Parang ano, ang hirap tanggapin, no? Ako, for me, yung anak ko, nagtitrabaho sa restaurant. So, it's, you know, alam natin na ang daming tao, di ba, sa restaurant. So, ang sabi ko sa anak ko, pakakainin kita ng isang taon, wala kang trabaho, sa bahay ka lang, hindi ka pwedeng pumasok. Tanggalin ka, fine, di ba? Dahil marami ka pang matatrabahuan pag hindi ka namatay sa COVID. After COVID, you can find a new job. But this time around, I won't allow you to work. Stay at home. That's my order. Diba? So wala. Hindi ko, I won't allow them to work. You know? No way. You know, in the restaurant, there are so many people that you don't know where they come from or what are their activities. So I cannot compromise the life of my child just because of money. No. Everything can be, you know, you can do something. Uh-huh. lalo na kung family, you can talk that this will be the budget, this will be this is just our money, so you have to extend that up to the blah blah blah, something like that. But we should not compromise the life and health of our children. So if I were the parents, I won't allow. Yeah, I won't allow my children to work at this time, and I won't allow my child to go to school. I am lucky enough that the university of my daughter has online classes, but my son, of course, I won't allow them to work. I don't have that money to pay in the hospital for COVID-19. It's million. Pag minalas-malas ka pa, patay ka dyan. Diba? So let's think about 100 times. That is my stand as an educator. Okay? As an educator and as a mother. Okay? So if you are new to this channel, please don't forget to click the subscribe button and the notification bell so that you will be updated for my upcoming videos. Have a nice day. Mabuhay!